Saloon Talk is brought to you by
No Stress, No Memos. But above all, no bad hair days.
Use Radiant Hair Products for a beautiful, natural you.
I don't know where the hell you've been, but it's been hot. Now, we tried to get to... John, this is my show. Thank you so much. We've been trying to get to know our guests better. So we've got to understand that Evelyn is in a long-distance marriage, okay? But when times get tough, she gets... or anything that works and sorts
not
things
anything.
Out.
What do you mean? Okay. I mean, I can't even use biringanya, Judithiana.
No, you've pushed the envelope far now.
No, she wants you to be specific. If times are hard...
She takes matters in her own hands.
Yeah.
Yes, that's all I'm saying. And then
that
now...
being a vigilante. Helping police to handle its own issues. Okay, anyway, my bad.
and then we have Andrew. Andrew's married, but then he's married, but he spends more time in the bar than in his marital home. But it's okay.
Hey.
It's fine, okay? It's
which is wrong. I'm married and I'm liberal-minded. I approach things the liberal
yes,
way.
Yes, he will catch you cheating and be like, baby, you know what? It seems it was my fault. You must have slipped and fell on that thing.
Why?
So you're liberal-minded?
No!
Hey!
Being liberal-minded, that means you take responsibility of what comes in your
no.
way.
No, see, if she tells you, baby, I slipped and fell on it, you're like, okay.
You slipped and fell on it?
Yes.
And who raised it, Kwanza? Who raised it?
Okay.
You must have incited it.
We're going to get it right into our topic. We're going to get into our topic. We're discussing the Kameza money. First of all, how much is enough? Okay? This is a topic that has always shown up in our other topics, but now we want to just focus on the Kameza money. Some of you may not understand the Kameza money. This is the money the man lives at home when he's leaving for work. So does it apply when you're dating a woman that works, that has a job, that makes money?
First of all, for all the men who are watching this show, however exposed you are,
however liberal-minded you are,
however, you, whatever you dub to be yourself, like your corporate CG high-end, just put that mumbo-jumbo down.
And?
I'll tell you what, this is Africa. Things happen. We don't have clear systems of insurance when the kid is actually sick and you're not home. You could have insurance, but again, a relative shows up and they need some money. So to me, Kameza is vital. And the best way to have a woman who
no,
does...
No, insurance
who
is available, honey. I don't know where you live, but when
you
your
leave
child
Kameza
is sick...
there and she won't use it and she keeps it. You know she didn't use it. Don't even ask where it went. Keep it.
Oh.
Time comes and she needs something. She will surprise you with a gift. You know, one time I got a watch from my woman, it was a Swatch, and she told me, I told her this is expensive. She said, I saved my Kameza money and I got this. Problem comes when women feel they're obliged to have this Kameza thing. And whenever you don't leave it there, you say, hey, Kyamagero. You don't remind me, no, but in Luganda
yes.
and in African setting, the
no
best way someone reminds
no
you.
No woman would do that. Would you tell a guy like that?
Reminds you that you've not done the right thing. They call your surname to take you back to your real roots. So they'll call even me, even if I'm mad, I say, Ndagire, by the way, and she's like, sorry.
She's a Mumbeja, be
absolutely,
careful.
And me, I'm a what? What are you talking about? I was saying, so... If you remind me that I didn't put that money there and you didn't first empathize why I didn't leave the money there, that's wrong.
The women who complain with their men, he leaves 10K at home. On that 10K, he wants a kwanjula bonanza. What do we call a kwanjula bonanza? There's some luombo, there's some chicken, there's some chinyewa, there's some beef, there's some matoke, there's some rice. And then on top of that, he wants balance.
You see, such men, I won't say they are not there. They are there, but they are not real. You see, men, the best thing men must have is financial discipline. If you earn, let me say, 100,000 per month, how much do you spend? Do you know I have to pay my wife salary, like, because she runs the farm I have. But every month, I have to give her a given sum of money. It's not Kameza, but it is her money.
Yeah. The problem could be is that you don't give her money for other things. If you don't give me money for sanitary towels, you don't give me money for new underwear, yet you expect, you didn't like the other one that had a hole in it. You said, baby, if that's not a design, please get rid of that. So you don't give me money for salon. You don't give me money for new shoes. I'm sorry. That 50 will never, that's why you have Katogo all the time.
That is what I'm telling you.
But then the 50K will.
You're cheating.
Yes, because
someone will go out to cheat.
But Evelyn, this is why I said we must have ground
money
rules.
Money is a very serious thing with
Evelyn.
No,
general. In everything we do, money is a constant.
General.
Those things of do you may have love and what you got, you'll commit suicide if you're betting on love. Money is a real thing. I'll tell you what, ground rules. Baby, every month I will need at least a 300K for me.
Mama Percy, hold on. Percy, I need you to give Percy the mic. Percy, tell me, is money that important in a relationship, is it?
Yeah, I think it could be the
you
main
think
thing.
You know?
It should be.
Madam, be sure. It is a must have. It is a constant. We should not patronize these things.
So are we going to say Bambi broke guys and do not have a chance at dating?
Broke guys have a very good future if they change the real life from being trivial and they work hard.
No one was born broke. Yeah. They must work hard and
earn. Yes. You cannot tell me you're going to date a guy who wakes up in the morning, sits on the border, plays Rudo all day, all round, and yet you have three jobs.
Yeah,
we're in a serious.
I buy ice cream on Nando's. It is all money.
No, but Carol, listen, Carol, you could get a guy like John and you build yourselves together, have a joint account like John said, and plan for your money. I'm saying, listen, Carol,
wait.
Carol, you could get a guy like John, build your lives together, have a joint account, bring you at the end of the month when you're paid, you bring your money, he brings his money, you plan together.
Joint account.
And it's a joint effort.
Even if he brings that money on our account, as a must, Kameeza think.
Let's be realistic. Money.
It is important every day, though you buy everything.
Even if he did the entire shopping and he still needs to live.
Even if you buy katunguru, katunguma on, you have to leave some money there.
Namwe, you guys, let's be honest. A joint account.
You want to tell us that you want a broke guy?
No,
she says she's dating a rich guy who has both. The guy has money and has a good...
No, listen.
Hey, why are you dating that one? Calm down. Excuse me.
If I have my mother in the village, I don't have to come again asking, like, you know what, sweetheart, you know my mother needs some chikoi. No, that money always leave at home. Did I buy my soap? Yeah, for my people, parents.
Yeah, I'll tell you. I caught you. You said we work together and we make a living together, so we have a right to share the finances. I'll tell you what. With financial discipline, it's a principle. The woman must have her separate account, and a man must have his separate account. As a man, these things of love fluctuates.
I'm a John, so he's
someone
separate.
Will go and take your money, and you, madam, love will fluctuate. I'll get your pin code.
One of these days, my rival called me.
And she likes your woman, your man.
Your rival, your position.
Side dish somewhere.
Side dish somewhere. Mm. Yeah.
Hey, your helper, yeah?
Yeah, she's like, I'm your rival, I'm somewhere. But you know what? Our man has got so many women. I'm like,
so she's calling for alliance.
Hey, hold on. When a woman is getting meticulous about the details, you shut up. In fact, hold it. She's going to finish this story when we come back. We need every detail. Be meticulous when you come home.
Look at Judithiana. Lord have mercy.
I know, right?
Muganda one.
I am the one and only Judithiana. Please stay tuned, because when we come back, we are going to know more. Anyways, Jen Saloon and Spa is located on Tinder complex opposite St. Luke's Church. Please come here, get your pedicure, get your manicure. If you're a bride looking for the salon of your choice, this should be it. This place is amazing.
I like it, Jay and Jay. I like them.
Hey.
I like the beautiful girls.
Beautiful
I like
girls. Yeah, like, oh well, me, like you can see, ladies and gentlemen out there. Yeah. Oh, Lord have mercy. Take me, Jesus.
What?
Take me, Jesus.
Okay, we'll be back. We'll be back. I can't.
Saloon Talk is brought to you by...
No stress, no memos. But above all... No bad hair days.
Use Radiant Hair Products.